According to American Diabetes Association diagnostic criteria, this is the recent diagnostic criteria of diabetes. Can you hear me? According to American Diabetes Association, the diagnostic criteria for diabetes. This is the recent diagnostic criteria for diabetes. Diabetes diagnosed किस तरह से होती है? HbA1c from HbA1c from fasting glucose from 2 hours glucose post meal after OGTT or random glucose. किसी भी एक तरीके से वी कैन डायग्नोज डायबिटीज बट एटलीस्ट वी हैव टू रिजल्ट्स फॉर डायग्नोजिंग द क्राइटेरिया फॉर अमेरिकन डायबिटीज एसोसिएशन इज दैट ओनली इन फॉर वन रीडिंग वी कांट डायग्नोज डायबिटीज वी हैव टू हैव टू रीडिंग्स एज इट इज रिटन रिजल्ट मस्ट बी कन्फर्म्ड बाय रिपीट टेस्टिंग सो वी हैव टू हैव टू रीडिंग्स एच बी ए वन सी मोर देन 6.5% And this is the standard lab, NGSP certified lab honi chahiye for diagnosing HbA1c as diabetic. Fasting glucose more than 126 or more than 7 millimoles. No caloric intake for at least 8 hours. Fasting should be of minimum 8 hours. 2 hours glucose after a 75 grams anhydrous glucose. This is called OGTT, oral glucose tolerance test. After an OGDT, 2 hours post meal, the sugar must be more than 200 to diagnose diabetes. Or random glucose. At random, if you have checked a glucose, it should be more than 200 milligrams. Plus, the patient should be having classical symptoms of hyperglycemia like polyuria, polydipsia, weight loss. If the patient is having hyperglycemic symptoms and you check the blood glucose and more than 200, you can diagnose diabetes. Okay. What are the clinical features of diabetes? Frequent urination, excessive thirst, unexplained weight loss, extreme hunger, sudden vision changes, tingling and numbness of the hands and feet. Feeling very tired much of the time, very dry skin, sores that are slow to heal, more infections than usual, most commonly UTIs. Sometimes we have no clinical features in diabetes. It is diagnosed at random. What are the types of diabetes? There are three major types of diabetes. Others are very rare, but they are present. Type 1 diabetes, which occurs mostly in children and young adults. Type 2 diabetes, which is more common in old age group, but now it is also common in young age group. GDM means gestational diabetes. This is during the pregnancy. In others, there's a lot of a very long list, but they are very, very rare. So we usually don't consider these things, but we used to know these things.
Slide move nahi ho rahi hai.
अब हुई
ऊपर जो येलो मार्क आ रहा है उस पे इनेबल एडिटिंग लिखा हुआ है
अच्छा ठीक है स्लाइड्स मूव नहीं हो रही है इनेबल एडिटिंग कर रहा है अब हुई है
नो मैम
कह रहे हैं इनेबल एडिटिंग करें ऊपर जो येलो मार्क आ रहा है उसमें
It is effective only and it embeds in the liver half like this.
Do you?
No, ma'am, abhi tak nahi hua, ma'am.
Any other questions or?
Aap sun lein kya keh rahe hain?
Hello.
दोस्त ये जो मैडम की स्लाइड जो रन की है आपने ये मूव नहीं हो रही है स्क्रीन शेयर में ना
ये क्या करना है बता
स्लाइड पे रुक गई है
रुक गई है
जी जी दोबारा बंद करके दोबारा खोल दें ट्रांजिशन इनको एनेबल एडिटिंग का मूव वो आ रहा है ना ऑप्शन आ रहा
है
फुल स्क्रीन कर दें आप उसको प्लीज
ठीक है
थैंक यू थैंक यू जुदा थैंक यू
ओके these are the clinical features. Have you seen the clinical features of diabetes? Now this is types of diabetes, type 1, type 2. GDM means gestational diabetes and others. The other form of diabetes is very, very rare. So we have to consider, first of all, type 1, which occurs in the young adults and children. Type 2, occurs in the middle and old age, but sometimes it can also be found in the young age. So gestational diabetes is diabetes during pregnancy. In others, we can, first of all, which is very common in others, is the drugs. Drugs may glucocorticoids, use of steroids is very common. If the patient is having pancreatitis or any problem of pancreas, like pancreatic surgery, pancreatic cancers, tumors, pancreatitis, anything regarding pancreas. So the insulin producing cells are lost, and when they are lost, the patient develops diabetes. Acromegaly, Cushing syndrome, genetic defects, the certain genetic defects which in which very common is MODY, M-O-D-Y. These are present in certain people and they develop diabetes, Down syndrome, and many others. So what is the, basically our topic is management of diabetes. What is the management of diabetes? Diabetes management, it occurs mostly, it is on the hands of the patient and the doctor. 50% is depend on the patient and the patient family. What kind of lifestyle the patient is living? What kind of occupation the patient is having? Is he mobile? Is he or she is having a sedentary lifestyle? What is the food intake he or she is taking? This is very important, is management of diabetes. Oral hypoglycemics and insulins. Now, for the type 1 diabetic, mainly is managed with insulin, only insulin, as well as dietary changes and exercise. For type 1 diabetes, there is no other option, rather anything else rather than insulin. And of course, we have to modify our diet and exercise. Different methods of delivery of insulin are now in fashion. Syringes, which is a rather old method of delivering insulin. Pre-filled pens, this is a rather new form of delivering the insulin, and insulin pumps. These are also used in Pakistan, but they are very limited. Their usage is very limited because of our less knowledge regarding insulin pumps, and there is less knowledge regarding insulin pumps among the doctors as well as among the patients, and it is very difficult to handle. That's why we are not using nowadays in Pakistan, but they are present in some areas, in some hospitals. Now, type 2 diabetes may be managed with non-insulin medications like oral hypoglycemics, insulin, weight reduction, and dietary changes. Again, the lifestyle modification. Now, medications. What are the medications found in type 2 diabetes? Can work in different ways. This is very important. Medications can work in different ways to reduce blood glucose level. They may increase insulin sensitivity. Jaise ki medicine ne foreign pancreas pe effect kiya, pancreas ke beta cells ko stimulate kiya, stimulate karke insulin sensitivity badha di. Theek hai? Insulin excretion badha di. Some may increase the insulin sensitivity, yani jo drug hum de rahe hain usne peripheral cells pack kiya aur usme insulin jo pancreas se nikal rahi hai uski sensitivity badha di. Now increase glucose excretion. This is not glucose excretion, sorry, this is increase insulin excretion. This is a mistake. Few drugs are increase insulin sensitive, the other drugs are increase insulin excretion. Few drugs act on the pancreas beta cells and they increase the insulin excretion. Few drugs decrease the absorption of carbohydrates which we take in our meals from the digestive tract. And the others have different mechanisms. Basically, these two, number one and number two, are the main medicines, and the others are rather new medicines which work through different pathways, like they work through incretin effects, they also work through gut hormones, and they also work through kidneys, which are called SGLT2 inhibitors. Now, what are the medications which are mainly used in type 2 diabetes? This is very important because we people have one or more, we people have many persons in our home as well who are diabetic, and we don't know what to use and what to give to that patients. The mainstay of treatment, metformin, this is a very noble drug, and this is a very cheap drug. It's very cheap and very effective, and this is a very old drug also. It is found in by the name of glucophage. Generally, metformin is the first line medication prescribed for type 2 diabetes, especially if the patient is obese. If the patient is obese and having insulin issues in the insulin sensitivity, metformin is the first choice until and unless the patient is having any contraindications. This is the drug which acts through this mechanism. Look. Increase insulin sensitivity. This is the drug which acts through increased insulin sensitivity, that it acts on the cells, peripheral cells, and it increases the insulin which is produced by the pancreas. The sensitivity of the insulin is increased so that the cell is capable of using more and more insulin in an efficient way. Now, sulfonylureas. These are the second most commonly used and old drugs. Relatively old drugs, and this is very effective. We use these drugs in the patients these drugs as a first line also in the patients who are thin and lean diabetic patients. So these drugs, the second sulfonylureas, act on by increasing the insulin secretion from the beta cells of the pancreas. Increase insulin excretion from the beta cell of pancreas. Meglitinides. Meglitinides are again the same as bigunides. Bigunides are those drugs which decrease absorption of carbohydrates from the digestive tract. These are the third drugs. Now, let me tell you one thing. In the Davidson, in the PK, whatever textbook you people read, these drugs are written like this. But in the clinical practice, we usually don't use these meglitinides and thiazolidinediones, because these meglitinides are very low potency drugs, and they have side effects. And these thiazolidinediones are high potency, but they are having many side effects. So according to the guidelines, the ADA guidelines, all these drugs are gone down. But in the textbook, they are written like this, and you have to remember, because in your exam you will be asked. But in the clinical practice, we don't use these meglitinides, and which are called bigunides and thiazolidinediones. In some of the patients, only few patients we consider. The most important and very fashionable drug is DPP-4 inhibitor. These drugs are very commonly used nowadays, and according to the DPP-4 inhibitors and the other, the SGLT2 inhibitors, we use these drugs very commonly. This is an enzyme, DPP-4. DPP-4 is the enzyme which is inhibited by these drugs. Hello? Which is inhibited by these drugs and by these drugs, by inhibiting these enzymes, we are able to the DPP-4 is a dipeptidyl peptidase 4, are the class of oral hypoglycemics that block the enzyme or inhibit the enzyme dipeptidyl peptidase 4, DPP-4. They can be used to treat type 2 diabetes mellitus. The first agent of this class is sitagliptin, which is approved by the FDA in 2006. How does the DPP-4 work? The DPP-4 works by blocking the action of DPP-4 enzyme, which destroys the hormone incretin. Incretins help the body produce more insulin only when it is needed, and reduce the amount of glucose being produced by the liver. इनक्रेटिन्स क्या होते हैं? इनक्रेटिन्स हमारे गट हार्मोन्स होते हैं, ठीक है, जो क्या करते हैं, इंसुलिन को ज्यादा निकालते हैं और ग्लूकोज को बनाना रोकते हैं लिवर से, ठीक है. इनक्रेटिन्स इंक्रीज द अमाउंट ऑफ इंसुलिन फ्रॉम द पेनक्रियास एंड इट डिक्रीज द अमाउंट ऑफ ग्लूकोज विच इज मेड बाय द लिवर. दिस इनक्रेटिन इज डिस्ट्रॉयड बाय द एंजाइम डीपीपी 4. But when we give DPP-4 inhibitors, the enzyme is inactivated and the incretin effect is highlighted. And there is more incretin, then there is more insulin, and there is less glucose. Now, GLP-1 receptor antagonist. GLP-1 receptor antagonist also acts like the same as the DPP-4. It also increases the incretin effect of the gut hormone. Incretin is a gut hormone which releases from the gut, and it increases the insulin secretion and decreases the amount of glucose which is produced by the liver. Now, it is very important that GLP-1 receptor is not an oral hypoglycemic. It is injectable hypoglycemic. This is the first non-insulin hypoglycemic, ya wo medicine jo ke insulin nahi hai, magar injection mein di jaati hai. Theek hai? This is very important. So learn regarding this. SGLT2 inhibitors, these are the very, very recent. People may ask you in the Viva, what are the recent drugs? So recent drugs mein DPP-4, GLP-1, and now the SGLT2 inhibitors. These are most recent drugs. This acts on the kidney, the sodium-potassium pump, and the sodium-potassium glucose pump. Okay, the SGLT2 inhibitors inhibit the SGLT2 pump in the kidney and in the tubules of the kidney, and it causes the glucose to secrete in the urine. जो glucose की absorption होती है kidney के through, जो kidney की convoluted tubules होती हैं उसके through, मतलब जो glucose हमने खाया, it is filtered from the kidney, and it when it filters from the glomerulus, it goes into the tubules, the proximal tubule, the convoluted tubule, and then distal tubule, and then outside. So when this filtered glucose is going through the tubules, it is reabsorbed by the tubules. But through SGLT2 inhibitors, the reabsorption is inhibited, and more glucose is excreted in the urine. So when the diabetics have high amount of glucose in the blood, they have hyperglycemia. जब ये दवाएं वो लेंगे, तो more and more glucose is excreted in the urine, और उनका glucose level blood से बेहतर हो जाएगा. So the last medications which we use in type 2 diabetes is insulin. The insulin which we use in type 1 diabetic and type 2 diabetics is all the same. Like it can be used in the syringes, it can be used in the pumps, it can be used in the pen fill devices. Now what are the complication of diabetes? Microangiopathy. Microangiopathy in the brain, which causes dementia, small vascular infarcts, theek hai? Retinopathy, cataract, glaucoma. We can have strokes, which can be microangiopathic, which can be cerebrovascular infarcts, and which can be hemorrhage. We can have myocardial infarctions and atherosclerosis, which causing angina and aortic stenosis as well. Hypertension, nephropathy, erectile dysfunction, peripheral neuropathy, we have diabetic foot gangrene, and we have different kind of skin infections, and we have urinary bladder dysfunctions and urinary bladder infections. We can also have GI side effects, which I think I have not mentioned here. We can have diarrhea, we can have constipation, and we can have gastropathy as well. Okay, now this is finished. If anybody can want to ask any question. Excuse me, किसी का सवाल है कोई? Questions कहाँ से पता लगे?
अस्सलाम वालेकुम.
वालेकुम सलाम.
मैडम लेक्चर एंड हो गया आपका?
जी.
सेकंड ईयर अभी. हेलो. एंड हो गया?
जी.
ठीक. तो पता है मैं ग्रैंड कर दूं?
किसी का कोई सवाल तो नहीं पूछना?
फिलहाल मेरे पास तो कोई क्वेश्चन नहीं आ रहे. आपके पास कहीं आ रहे वहां पर आ रहे तो मुझे बता दें।
नहीं इन्होंने तो ये लिखा है वी कैन हियर अनदर लेक्चर इन द बैकग्राउंड, वी कैन हियर अनदर लेक्चर इन द बैकग्राउंड,
ये तो पहले का था, अभी का नहीं।
ठीक है
तो मैं एंड कर दूं क्लास?
जी जी ओके
थैंक यू।